morning friends, my name is Emanudeep and today our topic is nomenclature of branch chain alkanes. Nomenclature of branch chain alkanes. So how do we name branch chain alkanes? And discussed while naming any compound according to IUPAC system, the very first rule to remember is selecting the parent chain with highest number of carbon atoms. So how do we select the highest number of carbon atoms? How do you select the chain with highest number of carbon atoms? Let me give an example. If you look at this compound, these two compounds are same, having same number of carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here also, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, how do we select parent chain? We know, we have to number the carbon atoms first. Now, let me number in the serial fashion, like this. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here I am getting how many carbon atoms? 6 carbon atoms. Now let me number in this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In this case, I am getting how many number of carbon atoms? 7 carbon atoms. So, what must be our parent chain? Chain with highest number of carbon atoms according to rule 1. Compare these two. If I number in this fashion, we are getting 6 carbon atoms. If we number in this fashion, we are getting 7 carbon atoms. So what would be our parent chain? Obviously, the chain with more number of carbon atoms will be our parent chain according to rule 1. So selecting in this kind of fashion is correct and this is wrong. This is wrong. So the very first rule to remember while naming any compound, any branch chain compound or any alkane, is we have to select parent chain with highest number of carbon atoms, like this. So this is rule number 1, selecting the parent chain with highest number of carbon atoms. The very first step while naming an organic compound. And another rule to be remembered is rule 2. Rule of first point of difference. Rule of first point of difference. Rule of first point of difference. So, what does rule of first point of difference says? It means we are discussing about nomenclature of branch chain alkanes. It means alkane chains, aliphatic compounds with branches. So, what does rule of first point of difference states is, while numbering a branch chain, compound, substituents of branches must be assigned least possible numbering. While numbering a branch chain compound, substituents branches, carbon atoms bearing substituents
or branches.
While numbering a branch chain compounds, carbon atoms bearing substituents or branches must be assigned least possible numbering. It means, let me take an example.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm having branch at this place and I'm having branch at this place. Let me say AB groups.
We have taken an example of an aliphatic chain containing
3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7 carbon atoms. Heptane. Heptane. So, according to rule 2, while numbering a branch chain compounds which are bearing substituents or branches, those carbon atoms must be assigned least possible number as much as possible. So, let me number like this. In this way. I mean, first way, assigning left to right, from my left hand side to right hand side, I am numbering like this,
left to right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
So, if you observe this, if you observe this molecule, while I am numbering from left to right fashion, I am having my substituents or groups at which carbon atoms? At the position of
4th and 6th.
4th and 6th. Now, let me assign number to this same compound in right to left fashion. From my right hand side to, I mean like this, in this way. Let me assign numbering from right to left.
This is my left to right fashion. This is my right to left.
Now, let me number.
Same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
If you observe this small, if this compound, if this kind of numbering in this fashion, I'm having my substituents at second carbon and fourth carbon. I'm having my substituents at
second and fourth carbon atoms.
Second and fourth carbon atoms. So, according to rule of first point of difference, what does it states? While numbering any branch chain compound, carbon atoms bearing substituents must be assigned lowest number as much as possible. Look at this. While I'm numbering this compound, this molecule from my left hand to right side, I'm having my group set 4th and 6th carbon atom. While numbering the same compound from my right hand side to left hand side in this fashion, I'm having my group set 2nd carbon and 4th carbon. So according to rule 1, number assignment is very lower to the 2nd carbon and 4th carbon. So according to the rule of first point of difference, assigning in this way is correct. And assigning in this way is wrong, because I must get least possible number to the substituents bearing carbon atoms bearing the substituents. So this is about rule 2. Let's take another example also.
CH3, CH2, 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 CH3. C2H5. I'm having this group and I'm having methyl group over here. These two are my substituents, these groups. One is ethyl group and another is methyl group. This is these are branches.
Now, let me assign numbers from my left hand side to right hand side. From my left hand side to right hand side.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So my substituents are at 4th and 6th. Let me assign the numbering to the same compound from my right hand side to left hand side.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I'm having substituents at 3rd and 5th carbon. So, according to rule of first point of difference, this will be right and this will be wrong, because we must assign least number to the carbon atoms in a chain bearing substituents. So, we will name the compound according to this fashion, from right hand side to left hand side. So, this will be right, naming from right hand side to left hand side. Let us name it. How many carbon atoms are there? 8. So,
oct.
Oct. This is alkane, saturated. So, octane. We have selected root word oct and ane, suffix of alkanes. So, now let's specify the groups. I'm having methyl group at 3rd position and ethyl group at 5th position. Right? So while writing, we must write 5-ethyl, 3-methyl, octane. So why? Methyl group is at 3rd carbon, ethyl group is at 5th carbon. Comparing with methyl group, ethyl group is far away, I mean at 5th carbon. But while writing, we have to mention first 5-ethyl and 3-methyl. It's because of its alphabetical order. Comparing with, while writing methyl and ethyl, which will get first according to its alphabetical order? Obviously E comparing with M. So we must follow alphabetical order while naming these kind of compounds. So I'll get, my name will be, compound name will be 5-ethyl and 3-methyl octane. So this will be the name of this compound. It's because of why we have written 5-ethyl first and then 3-methyl later, even though methyl group is present at 3rd carbon, we are following alphabetical order while naming this kind of compound. So comparing with M, it will be coming first. So we have to mention 5-ethyl first and then after 3-methyl, octane. Let's take another example. CH3, CH2, again we have substituted ethyl and methyl. Now let's number from left to right fashion.
One, this left to right. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And 9.
Now let me assign number from right to left fashion.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
While naming from left to right fashion, I am assigning numbering of my groups at third position and fifth position. While assigning from right to left, I am having my groups at fifth position and seventh position. So assigning in which way will be right? Obviously, left and right, according to rule of first point of difference. So we must name the compound. We must give name to the compound by following rule of first point of difference. I'm having 9 carbons, so my root word will be known. This is alkane, saturated. So my suffix will be ane, known ane. Here, I'm having ethyl group at third position and methyl group at fifth position. However, ethyl group is present at least number of carbon comparing with methyl group. We'll write ethyl first. If at all ethyl group is not present at least number of carbon also, we must mention ethyl first because of its alphabetical order. So my name will be 3-ethyl 5-methyl known ane. So this is about rule number 2, rule of least point of difference. So how do we name the compound if we are having same groups or same substituents in a given chain? If same substituents are present in a given chain. Let me take an example. CH3, CH2, CH, CH2, 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 CH3. And I'm having methyl group. Here also, let me say, I'm having methyl group. So I'm having same type of substituents in a given chain. So how do we name this? Let me number from this way: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And let me number from in this way: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We are following rule of least point of difference. From left to right, we are having groups at third and fifth. From right to left, fourth and sixth. Obviously, from right to left to right fashion will be correct. So I can write 3,5-dimethyl octane. Because I'm having same kind of substituent, same kind of groups at third and fifth position. So this will be the way of numbering. So let's take another example. Let me say I'm having CH3. CH3. How do we name these kind of compounds? So following rule of least point of difference, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here I am having 2 methyl groups at the same carbon. Here we are having 1 methyl group, only 1 methyl group. So this should be given priority. So 5, 8, this is octane.
So I must represent like this, 2,2-dimethyl. I'm having two methyl groups at one carbon, so 2,2-dimethyl or sorry, 2,2,4-trimethyl. Trimethyl octane. So let's discuss rule number 3. That is least sum rule. Least sum rule. So before discussing least sum rule, important thing to remember is, if a given chain is having more than two substituents, this rule is not acceptable. This is a special case. Special case. This rule is followed if substituents on a given chain are present at equivalent positions. Before knowing least sum rule, important things to remember is, if a given chain is having more than two substituents, this rule will be not followed and not accepted. And this is a special rule, special case, alternative to the rule of first point of difference. This rule is followed if substituents on a given chain are present at equivalent positions. So let's learn what is least sum rule. I have discussed this rule is applicable when substituents on a given chain are present at equivalent positions. If substituents on given chain are present chain at equivalent positions. Let me take an example of CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, methyl group. Methyl group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm having 7 carbon atoms here. So, according to the rule of first point of difference, we must assign numbering according to the branches. I mean, the branches, the carbon atoms in a given chain, So, according to the rule of first point of difference, carbon atoms in a given chain which are bearing substituents must be assigned lower number as much as possible. This is about rule of first point of difference. So, according to least sum rule, if two substituents are present at the equivalent positions. So, what about equivalent positions? Now, let's say 1, 2, 3. If I number from this, I'm having my group at third position. If I assign number from left to right fashion. Now, let me number like this. 1, 2,
3. If I assign numbering from right to left fashion also, I am having my group at third position. If I assign from left to right fashion also, I am having my group at third position. So substituents on a given when substituents are present on a given chain at equivalent position. So how do we name these compounds? How do we assign numbering for these kind of compounds? Important point to remember is numbering is assigned according to the alphabetical order of group or of substituents present on a given chain. So the numbering would be this is methyl group and this is ethyl group. According to the alphabetical order, ethyl group is pronounced first. So we must number in this way, in this fashion, from right hand side to left hand side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Root word is 7 carbon atoms. So root word is hept. Suffix is ane. This is alkane. So according to least sum rule, substituent which is cited first according to its alphabetical order must be given least number. So the name of this compound will be 3-ethyl 5-methyl heptane because of alphabetical order of this ethyl group which is pronounced first. Very important point to remember is this rule is followed. This is a special case when two substituents are at equivalent positions. If two substituents are at equivalent position in a given chain, then only this rule must be followed. If not, the rule of first point of difference will be employed to assign numbering or to give name to a compound. The rule of first point of difference is followed while assigning numbering or giving name to a compound.